Hello and welcome back to the Programming in C++ series. In this video, we're going to go over some of the exercises in Chapter 7, which deals with control user defined simple data types, namespaces, and string type. Alright, so in this video, the first exercise is going to be Programming in C++, Programming Exercise 7-7. But before we get deep into it, please go ahead and smash the like button. Leave a comment when it's done, and make sure you're subscribed to the channel. Alright, so let's go ahead on to see our first exercise, instructions. So this is a fraction calculator. Write a program that lets the user perform arithmetic operations on fractions. Fractions are of the form a over b, in which a and b are integers and b does not equal zero. Your program must be menu-driven, allowing the user to collect or select the operation plus, minus, multiplication, or division, and input the numerator and denominator of each fraction. Furthermore, your program must consist of at least the following functions. Function menu. This function informs the user about the program purpose, explains how to enter data, and allows the user to select operation. Function add fractions. This function takes as input four integer representation representing the numerator and denominators of two fractions, adds the fractions and returns the numerator and denominator of the result. Notice that the function has a total of six parameters. The function subtract fractions. This function takes as input four integers representing the numerator and denominator of two fractions, subtracts the fraction and returns the numerator and denominator of the result. Notice that this function has a total of six parameters also. And function multiplication, the function takes as input four integers representing the numerator and denominator of two fractions, multiplies the fractions, and returns the numerators and denominators of the results. And this also has six parameters. And function divide fractions, this function takes as input four integers representing the numerator and denominator of two fractions, divides the fractions, and returns the numerator and denominator of the results. Notice that this function has a total of six parameters. Some sample outputs are 3/4 plus 2/5 equals 23/20, and then 2/3 times 3/5 equals 6/15. So for task one, so here your answer need not be in the lowest term, so it's not going to factor it for you. In task one, program outputs correctly and contains required functions. So that's what we need to do. So let's go ahead and set up our program. Let's go ahead and do our cosmetics. No need for any new include statements, but we will have to do several functions, and we'll start on that right after this. Alright, our first function, we'll go to line 5 and we'll start. We'll call this one void add fractions. And they'll be very similar once we do. For instance, integer num1, integer num2, space num2, comma, denominator 1, int denominator 2, comma, and let's go. Then we have int ampersand num frac, lowercase, and then we'll do int, it's for numerator of fractions, int ampersand denominator frac. Semicolon that, and we'll use that again. So I'm going to copy and paste this whole parentheses along with a semicolon. All right, so let's go to our next one with the void. This will be subtract fractions. And copy that, same thing. And void multiply fractions in. Void divide fractions. And copy that again. Control V. Alright, so let's look at those, make sure they're good. One and two. Denominator one, denominator two. Numerator one, numerator two. Numerator fractions. Yep, and the thing is the same for that. Let's go on to our other functions. Let's do our menu one. Void menu. Then let's do void get fraction. And we'll do char space choice. Integer. Call that fract number. Or fract. No. Let's go int ampersand numerator and int ampersand denominator. Okay, so we're gonna go, so I'm waiting for that one, so I'm gonna make this extra comma. So we can do semicolon. Show result. And we'll do char operation. Int numerator one. Int numerator two. Is. Yep. So let's go, let's get one space for our main. All right, let's go to our main here. It makes a little room. And let's declare our variables, integer, numerator one. Two and we have denominator and denominator two. All right, then we have another one. Result number, result numbers. Good. Last one, we'll just do, just left that one. There was better one. Choice. Then we have menu, start that one. And then CIA, and use the choice with not equal 9. Let's do set choice. And we'll leave that open. Let's out for fraction one. Switch our cases. Switch choice would be the course. And let's do our bracket. So case one. And let's go add fraction. Fractions. And so we'll go numerator. Equals numerator one, numerator two, plus another bracket. There we go. One, numerator two, numerator two. This is going to be get quicker. Get the first one done. All right, so let's go break. Okay, so next we'll do case two by copy and paste this. See, boom, and we'll change this to case two. And since case two is going to be subtract. Thing, but everything else should be negative. That break. Let's go down again. Let's do case. case 3. Case 3 is going to be multiply. Fractions. And it's like that. Everything's going to be the same, except this is going to be asterisks. And in case 4. Case 4 will be, so case 4, 5 fractions. I'll turn this to a slash. Here, with the menu, Singolin, and then CN variable choice, Singolin. And should get a return 0 from there. So I guess it will. And let's just skip one space to return 0. And then now let's start working on our functions. First one, let's go with the, of course, add fractions. Before we add fractions, copy everything but the semicolon for the first one. Control C, bring it down 86, Control V, and let's put our brackets to start. And let's see, let's go num frac. Equals num1, numerator 1 times denominator 1. Or den, let's do den2, numerator 2, plus num2 times denominator 1. Right, so we're adding the denominator of the fraction. Next one, we're going to do void subtract fraction. Bring that down, copy that. And we'll paste that on 93. Use our brackets. And same thing, let's just do. Numerator to fraction, when you're subtracting, you go numerator 1 to denominator 2, and this time minus numerator 2, and then denominator 1 times denominator 2. It's the same. Okay. Oops. Anything else after that? Let's delete that twice. And let's do our multiplication. Fine, we're gonna make it easy this time. Alright, so let's go to send to account. times numerator 2, or denominator 2. So numerator 1 times numerator 2. And then denominator is going to be numerator 2 times. And we can do this simpler as well. You divide. You don't have to copy it. Numerator 1 times denominator 2. Numerator 2 times the numerator 1. There we go. Alright. Next, let's do our void menu. We'll just type that in. Save us some room. This is when we type up everything that needs to be said. It's for menu driven, so to speak. So let's go cout. This program performs operations on fractions. Next, so we'll do 4 of these total. 3, 4. So we'll do close 1, 2, 3, 4, and the last one to close. So we'll do 2 to subtract. A quick break, and right back after this. All right, so we got to subtract, to multiply, and to divide, and to exit the program. We go, won't use periods right there, but let's go ahead and do our 3. 4 and 9. So that's that for that one. And let's go ahead and let's do our next function, which is going to be a get fraction. Let's get this one, there's a decent amount of type in there. We can check to make sure our functions that we did use lost that those 3 dots off the first number, which they did. Alright, so let's get this one, get fractions. Fractions. There. Brackets. So we do cout. Enter the numerator. Cin, which is our variable, which will be do if choice is equal to 4 and frac no is equal to 2 and numerator is equal to 0. Okay, these are cases. Out divide 2 divide second fraction must be not zero. Equals 0 brackets C out enter a non-zero number for the numerator. So it's one more semicolon. Use a variable numerator. C out combine. And let's go and let's close this up. To the denominator. Out the denominator must be non-zero. But that will definitely work. void, show results. Result that is all but semicolon, just copy that. Bracket, and we'll see out so variable number, numerator 1, and then we'll use scope division. Leave space for that, bring it that tight. It's an operation. Show. And we'll do a bracket. But case 1. No, let's not do it. Let's do case minimum plus. Case plus. Colon. And we'll tell it to see out. This time we'll leave a space plus, and then we'll use our break. Alright, so we got a few more of those to go. So let's just copy and paste these in there. Boom. Alright, so next we'll do case minus. Minus. And we'll do case asterisk. Drop the asterisk. And we'll do case division. Drop the division. Alright. So let's do our default. Let's go step here, step outside here, and let's do C out and do some variable numerator 2, and division inside there, numerator 2. Okay, we're at the top. Let's go ahead and run this. See if we got everything in order. So that's one add fraction. That's enough. That's enough. try to calculate it while we show the code. And let's scroll over. And here we go from line 1 through 18. Remember, just pause as you need to. So we're going to scroll down 19 to 35. Pause if you need to. We're scrolling down. 36. Okay, we got something wrong here. Look at that. Check for pass, pass, pass. Pass, pass, fail. So I need to find these numbers from orange to fractions. Check out that. All right, we didn't mess with the code, but we're gonna run it again and try to do all the features. Let's see, run to add fractions. Let's go 4/5. Oh, let's not do that. Let's not do that. Let's go back. Let's run it again. Yeah, put a fraction as a numerator and then crash the program. So that shouldn't happen. Let's go. Alright, let's pause this again. Alright, we're going to run this again. This time I'm going to go through all of the so I'm going to restart it again because it won't run the code. So let's close it up. Go back to that. And go back here and restart it again. Alright, we'll be back when it restarts. Alright, we restarted it. Let's go ahead and try to run it now, and it's running. So I'm going to try to go through all the functions this time and calculate the grade. So let's go 3/5/8. Fraction 2, 3/5. So that is 15/24. Then let's go 2 for subtract. Let's go 7/8. So I'm going to show you the calculate the grade this time. If it doesn't get 100, then you'll get 83.3. I didn't see anything wrong with it, but that's about as much time as I'm going to spend. But let's go ahead and go through these again. That's 1 through 18. If I find out later that something's wrong, I'll fix it. But I think it's correct. I don't see how anything is wrong with it, other than I didn't go through the whole spectrum the last time. That's 20 to 37. Pause that as you need it. That's 38. To 54, and then that's 55 to 71, and then that's 72 to 88, and that's 89 to 105. To 124, and that's 125 to 142, and here's the whole line to 125. If you didn't copy and paste it, if you didn't type it out or whatever, that's the rest of the line for that function. Alright, so now moving on, and that is 146 to 162. And 163 to 179, and here we go, the bottom of the code. And it looks like it gave us our 83.33 again. I'm going to run you through the code one more time. If you can figure it out, that's great. You get the extra points for that one. I'm going to slow scroll it for you again. Pause it as you need it. Once again, the get fraction function. Here's the other side of that one. And I'm scrolling down as well. See the errors in the code, but like I said, I've looked at it long enough. If you find something, just put it in the comments. If I find anything later, I'm going to push on through. I'll put it in the comments or description of the video. Alright, so there we go, the last function. And there you go. Alright, so let's jump on to our next exercise. This one's going to be programming in C++, programming exercise 7-8. Here we're going to write a program that reads in a line consisting of a student's name, social security number, user ID, and password. The program outputs a string in which all the digits of the social security number and all the characters of the passwords are replaced by X. The social security number is in the form 0. There's dashes like a regular social security number, and the user ID and the password do not contain any spaces. Remove the dashes from the social security number in your program output. Your program should not use the operator array symbol to access a string element. Use the appropriate function described in table 7-1, which is this one here. So we got the star, string, var, dot clear, append. Those as needed. And let's go on. Program outputs correctly, so we'll keep those functions in mind and use them as appropriate. Alright, first thing we need to add a couple include statements. So we will do that, starting with the include string. Then we'll add the F stream. Alright. And let's go to our admin. Go straight to that. Start clearing our variables. So gotta look. Yeah, let's leave some room for cosmetics, leave some room to work. And let's go with string student info. Let's go with another one. This time let's use our double colons. Use its size, type, POS equals 0, semicolon. Then let's use string again. And then use size type. This time we'll do sub, str, substring, length. So we're going to put a length in there for social security numbers. Since they're all the same length, it's like a phone number you can use that with too. Alright, so let's get popping with cout. Enter a student's name. Social security number. Let's put this down. User ID. Let's put this user ID. Comma. And password. for int integer I equals 0, semicolon, and then I less than 9, semicolon, and let's increment I plus plus. Brackets, PLS, student, info, find, find first, F, and let's make this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Statement. Let's do some more POS info student info define, and this time let's go space between that and let's comma POS semicolon. Let's copy that. This time, let's add plus one. Plus one. All right. And we got string it. So we'll use that will equal student info. Your substring. Substring again, length equal temp, ndth, semicolon. Let's make temp equals true, semicolon. Colon, size type, number I equals 0, semicolon, and I has to be less than substring length minus 1. Place plus plus one and substring length and temp. It's all think that's all we need. Let's go check for errors and then password. Alright, no errors found. So let's go ahead and try to run it. Screen number and password, so I did that. So I think we're good to go. Let's go ahead and calculate and show you the code. Calculating. Let's go ahead and look at that. So here's line 1 through 18. Make sure you pause if you need more time, as always. Scrolling down to 19 to 35. And then from 36, which is blank, to N. So we're right there. 40. And we got our green check mark and 100% on that one. So I'll show you again. This time we'll scroll slowly, pause as needed. This was a short one. And there we go. All right. So back up, pause as you need it. So thanks for joining us. That one. We'll go on to that's 4-7-8. We'll go on to our next exercise right after this. Programming in C++, programming exercise 7-9. And here you are given a file consisting of students' names and the following from last name, first name, middle name. Another student may not have a middle name. Write a program that converts each name to the following form. First name, middle name, last name. Your program must read each student's entire name in a variable and must consist of a function that takes as input a string consists of a student's name and returns a string consisting of the altered name to print to the terminal. Use the string function find to find the index of comma and semicolon. The function's length to find the length of the string and the function's substring to extract the first name, middle name, and last name. Alright, so task 01 program outputs correctly. So let's go ahead and get started. So once again, let's add our include statements. We'll need two. First one will be, we'll need string, of course. And then we will include the F stream. Alright, nothing neat there. So let's go ahead and do our function, call it string convert name, and this one will be string and name and semicolon. Let's go down to our main, our cosmetics, create a little room to work. Let's go there and let's start declaring our variables. Of course you're going to have string. And let's go if stream. So we have file in file and of stream out file and in file. We're going to open chapter 7. Underscore exercise 9 data.txt. That's the file. And of course, if we can't find that file, or it doesn't open for whatever reason, we're going to print out this phrase. So out file does not exist. Program terminates. And let's inline there. And then we'll return one. There we go. All right. Next, let's go, on up. Then we're going to get line. There we go. Alright. So let's go while in file. There's some brackets. Yeah, let's do cout. Convert name. And then let's do name. Statement. Now we need to close. File.close. And return 0. Alright, let's jump in a function. It's only 1. So string, convert name. Bracket, and let's go integer length will equal name.length gth return anything, semicolon, and then goes int index equals name.find. String 0 index. So we're not using our array. String remaining name. Equals name dot substring. Index plus 2, middle and last. Name. Alright, so there we go. Let's scroll up, see if we had any mistakes or any misspells. Let's run it just to make sure. And there's our names. I don't have middle names, but they're added to the list. So looks good. And let's calculate grade while we show you the code. So we got 1 through 18. Please pause if you need more time with those. We got 19 to 35. I'm going to scroll over to where in line, you see how this line ends. You can pause it if you need more time, as always. All right, let's go down to 36. Let me see if we got our green to the end of the code. That's the end of it. We got a green check mark, and we got 100% grade, so that was perfect. And we'll slow road it one more time for you. Remember, you can pause it whenever you want. Scroll over so you can see that line 21 all the way again. There you have it. One down, zero function. And we're good to go. Alright, so thank you for checking, watching this video. If I do have a solution, as I mentioned before, to the 7-7, whichever one didn't get 100%, it only got 83.33. I will leave something in the comments or in the description. If you find it before I do, please put it in the comments. We will really appreciate that. Also, for this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. And we'll see you on the next one. Thank you again. Have a wonderful day.